everybody. My name's Luke Stratton. I do sound and lights for Dopapod. This is my world. So I guess I'll start with my lighting world, and then we'll go through that, and then move over here to audio. I use a program called Grand MA2 on PC. It's designed to run on a big, full lighting console, but basically I used to be a software programmer, so I programmed the whole desk onto a bunch of MIDI boards. So these are like, this is an APC-20 and an APC-40, and an Innovation Launchpad Mini, and an Akai LPK-25. And they're usually for like DJing or whatnot, and I've kind of put them all together inside of a DJ case that I treated as a lighting console. Grand MA is pretty sophisticated software, so I guess I'll kind of just quickly go through how my board's laid out for those nerds out there that are super interested. The APC-20 is usually colors, and the APC-40 is most everything else. It's got a few more buttons and knobs, so I've got some effects and stuff. But on my normal page, this is my color grid. So the top here, I've got solid colors for the whole rig. You can see here. And they're kind of in order as they are on the color wheel inside my lights, so that if I go from red, I know that red and blue are close, so I can do quick movements without seeing a jump. If you go from blue to UV here, you see it jumps through the wheel. And then I have it sorted by fixture, so if I wanted to color the movers yellow, the upstage wash blue, downstage wash purple, I can do that all manually down. I've also got all that stuff on a fader here, like a fade time fader, if you will. So I can actually put this guy all the way up, dial a new look in, and then snap it down when I'm ready for that look to hit. I can also kind of give it a fade, so if I want to go fade to red here, I can just put the fader up a little bit, and the whole rig will slowly turn red. Below that, I got some gobos and some other page changing buttons. But then on the bottom of each APC, I have this whole big grid here. I use what I call a color theory. So basically, I go from like magenta and pink through red, and through all the colors of the rainbow up here back through to pink. And then I try to go bright looks, medium looks, and dark looks. So that way I can kind of hit a color look without having to think about it. So for example, if I want a bright yellow look, I can click this button and it'll pop to a rig that has yellow in it that's bright. It may not be all yellow. But then if I want like a dark green look, over here. Now, as far as the actual color looks, I have this whole system where I've got them all named with really creative names to help me remember how to use them. For example, the one I just hit is called Alderaan. I'm a big Star Wars geek. Over here I've got Fireplace, which is kind of obvious, but I've got probably 100 of different color looks to help me kind of remember how I use it. Some classic yet obvious ones are Rainbow and Rasta. So that's mostly the 20 and part of the 40. Down here on the bottom, I've got faders on the left one. The left side faders here are usually for what are called specials, so I can spotlight on a member of the band. But on a bigger rig where I've got a lot of conventional lights, sometimes I'll have to use some of these faders to control the red park hands. The second set here are some movement faders, so if I want to make the lights move in a certain kind of direction, I can. Now over on the APC-40, I got a bunch of other stuff. This top row here is positions, so I could point the lights down, or make it X's, or point them at the wall. But those all key off this fader here, so if I want them to fade slowly to down, I just put this fader that low, hit down, and it goes. It's kind of fun. I got a lot of positions, and I got some double stacked positions, so if I hit the button twice, it goes to a different position. What else I got? So this little button grid here are my strobes. So I've got like a park hand, wash strobe, and then a mover strobe. I've got an all white strobe. And then I've got a button called Freak Out, which is basically color, spin, and prism, and it's the works. Then the next little grid section down here are all my chases, and those key off the fader too, so I can kind of play things along with the band. Over here are iris buttons to kind of change the shape of the beam. You can see a small iris or big iris, or you can frost it all the way out. And then some, you know, kind of color effects, all kinds of stuff scattered here. Got some gobos over here, which for those not in the industry, those are like the shape that the light makes. So you'll see this is a triangle or a circle, some lines. As far as my knobs, I got these are mostly all movements, and then things like prism speed, gobo scroll speed, gobo rotation speed, and color speed. Then, you know, I get asked a lot what all is going on, and I hear people see the keyboard, and they're like, oh, you got a keyboard, where you play notes back there? And these are all bumps for the rig, so I've got some, I can black out the rig, and I can bump in the LEDs for all these different colors. Or if I've got the rig on, it'll shift the rig to that color, but they're temporary, so when I let go, they kind of go back to it. I've got some blackout bumps and some turn-on bumps, some wipes here, and that kind of stuff. So I guess that's pretty much my light rig, more or less. I guess I should talk real quick about what we're using. Our touring rig is 6 Elation Platinum Spot 5Rs. It's a pretty relatively cheap, bright fixture that moves pretty quick, and it's kind of my main workhorse. So all my programming that I have for those 5Rs, I'll walk into a bigger room and I'll do what's called clone. I'll clone that for programming from our lights. Then we also have a bunch of LEDs that we have. So this is my audio world. Yeah, so we tour with a Presonus Studio Live 2442. It's a 24-channel console. For years we toured with my 16-channel one, but we finally grew out of that one, and this board gives me a few more options. We get to have a few more things in stereo, make a few more drums. I'm running this guy with a through FireWire 800 right into our MacBook Pro. And on this I'm running 2 pieces of software. I'm running the main control program, which is called Universal Control, which is great for kind of seeing spectrographs of what's going on with the audio, but then also it's what lets the guys control their in-ear monitor mixes over their iPhones. This program is the key for that. The other thing I use is Presonus Capture 2, which is just a really simple audio recording program. It basically records everything that comes into this board before I've even done anything to it, to the hard drive. So that no matter what I do with the mix, if I get creative or something's too loud, this will capture it before that. So if I go back to mix a show and release it online, it's already it's unprocessed. So it's pre dynamics in EQ. It's a great console. One of my things I love about it, I mean, a lot of digital consoles have a lot of these features now, but when I first made the switch, you know, every channel has 4-band parametric EQ, compression, key gates or expanders, limiters. It's just, it lets me really dial in every single channel so that I'm not necessarily worried about each individual channel so much more. I can just focus on the whole thing. Everybody's on in-ears now except for Rob, who's got his own QSC monitor, so he lets us roll into any room and kind of be able to put the same show on. I think that's pretty much it. You know, I could go into the microphone cabinet that we tour with, but I think I'll save that for more of the audio nerd types. Yeah, any questions, feel free to email me at luke@dopapod.com. Hope to see you guys at a show.